Hey, friends, it's good to see you. I'm glad some of you are tuning in. Gonna make it nice and easy tonight. Just keep it nice and mellow. It's good to see y'all. Ring, ring, telephone ring. Somebody said, baby, what you doing? Been wondering where you've been. Now and then I think about you and me. There's no use fighting about the things we can't recall. It don't matter now at all. Just come on home, baby, we'll laugh and sing. We'll make love and let the telephone ring. Ring, ring, doorbell ring, baby, come on in. I got Jim Croce on the stereo. Glad you come around. I've been feeling down, talking to Tony and Mario. Conversation. Still, it ain't no consolation. Cause I got love, and baby, I'll give you some. And if somebody comes, let the doorbell ring. Ring, ring, golden ring, around the sun, around your pretty finger. Ring, ring, voices ring with a happy tune. Anybody can be a singer. The sun comes up across the city. Swear you never looked so doggone pretty. Hand in hand we'll stand upon the sand with the preacher man. Let the wedding bells ring. All hand in hand we'll stand upon the sand with the preacher man. Let the wedding bells ring. All hand in hand we'll stand upon the sand with the preacher man. And let the wedding bells ring. That's a song by Alex Harvey. I've always loved that song. And speaking of Jim Croce, I got a Jim Croce song. And this is from his first ABC album. I've always loved this. It's called Walking Back to Georgia. Walking back to Georgia, and I hope she will take me back. Nothing in my pockets, and all I own is upon my back. But she's the girl who said she loved me on that hot, dusty Macon road. And if she's still around, I'm gonna settle down with that hard-loving Georgia girl. Walking back to Georgia, she's the only one who knows how it feels when you lose a dream, how it feels when you dream alone. But she's the girl who said she loved me on that hot, dusty Macon road. And if she's still around, I'm gonna settle down with that hard-loving Georgia girl. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Georgia, can you hear me calling? Well, I'll be home in just a while. And if I had to, I'd be crawling just to share another morning smile. But you're the girl who said you loved me on that hot, dusty long ago. And if you're still around, I'm gonna settle down with you, my hard-loving Georgia girl. I'm walking back to Georgia, and I hope she will take me back. Nothing in my pockets, and all I own is upon my back. But she's the girl who said she loved me on that hot, dusty Macon road. And if she's still around, I'm gonna settle down with that hard-loving Georgia girl. Walking back to Georgia. Hey, it's good to see everybody. There's just a few of us, but that's all right. You know, that makes it a little more intimate. I've got a few things planned, and if I have time, I'll get to some requests. I see I already have, Peggy is from Georgia. I see I already have a request for some Gordon Lightfoot. I would love to get some Gordon Lightfoot from my friend Sean back home. I want to do a song. I'm going to do some original songs for you. I thought, you know, that might be kind of cool tonight. It's Memorial Day weekend, and I hope y'all are out there and enjoying it. I know you're probably at home, but that's okay. If you're enjoying it with somebody that you love. Got a song that I wrote, and this was on my Heroes, Clowns, and Crooks CD. Wrote this with a couple of friends of mine, Jimmy Young and Ira Allen. Of love to drown in, sky full of dreams to dream. So I promised you the moon and a cloud with a silver lining that took you to a shack in New Orleans. And we had oceans of love to drown in, a sky full of dreams to dream, a Louisiana moon to give our clouds their silver lining. We had love in our shack in New Orleans. Time went by, success brought many changes. Now we're living very well in Bowling Green. But the things that matter most to me now, we left inside our shack in New Orleans. And we had oceans of love to drown in, a sky full of dreams to dream, Louisiana moon to give our clouds a silver lining. We had love in our shack in New Orleans. Now we're not in touch with each other, we're not out of reach by any means. Brought us close together are still inside our shack in New Orleans. There's still oceans of love to drown in, a sky full of dreams to dream, a Louisiana moon to give our clouds a silver lining. There's still love in our shack in New Orleans. There's still oceans of love to drown in, a sky full of dreams to dream, a Louisiana moon to give our clouds a silver lining. There's still love in our shack in New Orleans. Let's go back to our shack in New Orleans. In New Orleans. All of these songs on the Heroes, Clowns, and Crooks album I wrote with either one or two of my friends down here in Nashville. I always get a request for this next song that I got the idea for when I was working years ago at a club up in Muncie, Indiana. And when you would walk in the front door, on your right-hand side there was this picture of called the Boulevard of Broken Dreams. And it had Humphrey Bogart and Marilyn Monroe and Elvis Presley and James Dean. And I always thought, man, what a great picture. And I knew there was a there was already a song called Boulevard of Broken Dreams. But I wanted to write a song for that picture. And this is the one that I came up with. It's called Broken Dream Cafe. Love that song. I've got another song from the same album, and I'd already written like the bridge and the chorus to this song, and I was kind of looking for something else. And I came to Nashville, and I was staying at the Best Western at the time. It was on Stewart's Ferry Pike, And so I was waiting for a couple of my friends, songwriter friends, to come over, and we were going to do some writing. And I thought, well, this might be a good song. So I went across the street over to a convenience store to pick up some, like a cup of coffee and something on, and head back to the room. And as I was standing there getting ready to pay, I noticed all those, you know, they got the tabloids right there as you're waiting to check out, you know, like the Star and the Inquirer and all those, and they got those real funky, weird headlines, you know. So I picked up a bunch of those and I took them back to the room, and when my co-writer friends got back to the room, I said, hey man, this is the song that I want to write. And they're looking at me like, are you crazy? You got all these weird magazines. But it ended up being a pretty good song and ended up being the title of the album. Amazon tribe worships Elvis. He's the king of the jungle now. Alien cattle abducted a farmer as he drove them to town. Castro caused some LA riots. I read it in the Weekly Sun. Just last week he got drunk in a bar with an honest congressman. None of us here are innocent, so none of the names have been changed. I'll tell you the stories just how they happen, but the truth can be arranged. My lies are based on a true story, straight from the pages of an open book. Here's to the pleasure, pain, and glory, and all the heroes, clowns, and crooks. Drinking booze improves your memory. No more drinking to forget. A pregnant man delivers pizza. There's no smoking cigarettes. I was a teenage werewolf back in my younger days. Now I'm an agent for the FBI and the ASPCA. None of us here are innocent, so none of the names have been changed. I'll tell you the stories just how they happen, but the truth can be arranged. My lies are based on a true story, straight from the pages of an open book. Here's to the pleasure, pain, and glory, and all the heroes, clowns, and crooks. My lies are based on a true story, straight from the pages of an open book. Here's to the pleasure, pain, and glory, and all the heroes, clowns, and crooks. Heroes, clowns, and crooks, they were all in those magazines. That's where they were. I was just waiting to unlock that song, and that's what it took to unlock it, all those strange tabloids. A couple of weeks ago, I made a video of a song that I had recorded many years ago, Rubo's Tea. It's pretty good. I like it. And I had recorded this song many years ago. I think it was like 1986 when I had first come to Nashville and brought with me a bunch of songs. And I found out when I had first moved to Indiana, gosh, it was 1985, I believe. And I was up there doing some things. And I was watching TV one day and I saw a great friend of mine that was on TV. And he was promoting an album that he had just recorded called Cabbage Patch Doll. His name's Ira Allen. And so I did some calling around and I found out that he had moved to Nashville. And so I got in touch with him and he said, come on down, we'll do some writing and whatever. And so went down and wrote a bunch of songs with Ira. It ended up being an album called, what was the name of it? I don't even remember the name. Don't remember the name of the album, but it's out there somewhere. I think it's on a cassette. I think my aunt Sharon has a copy of it. But anyway, I think one of the first songs that we wrote together and we actually recorded was this song, and I don't remember where I came up with the idea, but I've always loved it. It's called Gypsy Wind. She was a gypsy wind blowing across my soul. She was a gypsy wind, impossible to hold. She was warm and lovely, she was soft and free, moving through my life and heart as a gentle breeze. When I thought I could hold her till the end of time, I should have realized she never could be mine. She was a gypsy wind blowing across my soul. She was a gypsy wind, impossible to hold. I'm tied to a memory, she's bound to be free. I see her in the moonlight, looking back at me. And she is out there somewhere, and she is on her own. Someone might be holding her, but he doesn't know. She is a gypsy wind blowing across my soul. She is a gypsy wind, impossible to hold. She is a gypsy wind blowing across my soul. She is a gypsy wind, but how was I to know? Gypsy Wind. I've always loved that song. That was the first song that we'd not only recorded, but I wrote that with Ira Allen and Jimmy Young, another good friend of mine, who I had only met that night when we went in to write the song, and we had become really good friends since then. But yeah, we recorded all that stuff down at LSI Studios and Merritt Studios, all just right off of Music Row down in Nashville. And I was so impressed with all the musicians that as they started walking in, I actually recognized some of them, and I was kind of afraid, because I had never worked with that caliber of a musician before. So Tony Migliori was one of he was the piano player, and he's worked with everybody, people like that. So last year, I'm a member of this group called Fellowship Songwriters, and there's several of us that before the virus and everything, we would meet at Papa Turney's Barbecue on the at the marina down on Old Hickory, I mean not Old Hickory, on Percy Priest Lake down in Nashville. But we hadn't had the opportunity to do that recently, so hopefully we'll get that started up again. But last year, I'd been going down there and sharing some of my songs with some amazing songwriters. And so they started this, they were going to have a contest and write a theme song for Papa Turney's. And so I wasn't going to write a song because there were so many great songwriters, and I thought, you know, I really don't need to. So I kind of put it off and put it off. And about a week later, I got a call from a couple of the people that are over all the fellowship songwriters, and they said, hey, are you going to write a song? When are you going to send us something? I said, well, man, there's so many great songwriters. They said, no, just write a song. And so I did, and I put it on a video and I sent it. And about a week later, they said, hey, you know, you're nominated, you're in the finals, so come on down and we'll see. So it ended up, my song won, and we went into the studio last year and cut the song. And there were different things that happened during the recording that they weren't really happy with, so we were going to go back into the studio and record, and we did. I recorded my parts, and I think they were going back in to record background vocals, and then I had to go out on the ship, and we said, okay, when we get back, we'll finish it up, but unfortunately the virus hit, so we haven't been able to get back into the studio to finish up the song. But I wanted to play you just a little acoustic version of Papa Turney's Shuffle. It's a really bluesy thing when you hear it in the studio. When you hear the final version, I hope it's soon, it's really kind of cool. Come on in, grab a seat, chill all your friends, it's a place to meet. Shuffle down to Papa Turney's. Shuffle down to Papa Turney's. Shuffle down to Papa Turney's barbecue. Got smoking bands that play the blues. Home of the world's best barbecue. Shuffle down to Papa Turney's. Shuffle down to Papa Turney's. Shuffle down to Papa Turney's barbecue. They got open mic, Ridehurst night. Come and get your fill of barbecue delight. Shuffle down to Papa Turney's. Shuffle down to Papa Turney's. Shuffle down to Papa Turney's barbecue. Well, Papa Turney's wife, her name is Zeke. She keep the juke joint jamming 5 nights a week. With original tunes, a cover songs, they got the juke joint jumping all night long. Shuffle down to Papa Turney's. Shuffle down to Papa Turney's. Shuffle down to Papa Turney's barbecue. Shuffle down to Papa Turney's barbecue. Shuffle down to the world's best barbecue. So that's Papa Turney's Shuffle. Hopefully we'll be able to get back into the studio and finish that song up before too long. I've got a song that... another song that my friend Ira Allen and I wrote, and we've recorded the demo, but it has not been recorded yet because we wrote the song. It's for a girl singer, and so we haven't really found the girl singer that we've been really hoping for, but eventually we'll get that done, I think, I hope, because it's kind of a cool song. I hope you like it. It's called Don't Get Me Started. could cause a fire, you'd be hotter than the sun. If passion was a bullet, you'd be the smoking gun. Just like a spark at a tank of gasoline, gonna be a big explosion if you get too close to me. Don't get me started. Don't get me started. Don't go fooling around with something you don't know about. You'll ignite a fire you never will put out. Don't get me started. Sugar, I got this feeling you're about to start something I can't stop. Baby, you better be careful. Don't be picking up things you can't drop. I know what you're thinking. It might be cool to check it out. But if you're not sure, beyond a shadow of a doubt. Don't get me started. Honey, don't get me started unless you wanna feel a grown man burn. Baby, you better get ready. Once you strike that match, there's no return. Just like Jimmy Johnson sitting on the pole. If you don't wanna fire, you're racing out of control. Don't get me started. Oh, oh no. Don't go fooling around with something you don't know about. You'll ignite a fire you never will put out. Don't get me started. If good looks could cause a fire, you'd be hotter than the sun. If passion was a bullet, you'd be the smoking gun. Just like a spark and a tank of gasoline, gonna be a big explosion if you get too close to me. Don't get me started. Don't get me started. Don't go fooling around with something you don't know about. You'll ignite a fire you never will put out. Don't get me started. Don't get me started. Don't get me started. Oh, no.
Yeah. So if you're a girl looking for a song, there's one for you. Don't get me started. A few years ago, I went home and sometime before that, I was out on a ship and I was feeling kind of homesick and melancholy. And I wrote a song called "I'd Love to Go Home, But Home Isn't There Anymore." Just talking about different memories about home and realizing that because of previous trips back home, that a lot of it wasn't there anymore. A lot of the town where I grew up had changed so much, and you hardly recognize it. But a couple of years ago, I went back home and went down to look for my grandma and papa's old farm. And I went up and down the road, back and forth, and I thought I knew where it was, but I couldn't find it. And so I went home, or back to my brother's house, and I said, "Man, I thought I could find it, but it's not there. I don't know, it's not there." And he goes, "I know where it's at." So The next day we went down there and we went back and forth up and down the road, you know, because it had grown so much when my grandparents lived out there. It was way out in the country and you could find their house no problem. But it had grown up so much that we didn't recognize any of it. When we finally recognized where it was, and it was behind this big chain link fence, and so we drove into the driveway, and behind the old house, which is now a business building, it's a road construction office. And so we drove around back and parked and looked around. It was all where all the fields and pastures and everything were. It was all blacktop and concrete, and there were condominiums and apartments and road construction equipment sitting all around. And so we walked up to the house and they let us come in and look around, and it was still basically the same. You know, you could see where the kitchen was. It was still the kitchen, but it was a little different. And all of the living room and the bedrooms and everything, they were being used for offices, but it was still basically the same. And so the lady that worked there, one of the ladies, she was like the lead office person. She said, come in. I want to show you something in the bathroom. And I said, the bathroom? She said, see where these sinks are? And I said, yeah, but it doesn't look right. And she goes, yeah, that's right, because there used to be an old clawfoot bathtub in there. In fact, it's still in there, but they had to encase it because of some zoning laws or something. They couldn't remove that old bathtub. So they had to just encase it and put the sinks over it and everything. So that was kind of cool. And it was really nice seeing that, but it fit right into that melancholy song, I'd Love to Go Home, but home isn't there anymore. Our apartments where my papa's farm used to be. When I was a kid, his cows would follow after me. Out across the fields we'd go, then back to grandma's door. I'd love to go home, but home isn't there anymore. I can almost see Tiger Mountain in my mind, rising up like it was painted on the clear blue sky, where the spruce and Douglas fir once grew. They've all been cleared away for a better view. I'd love to go home, but home isn't there anymore. I've been away too long. So much has changed since I've been gone. And the more I roam, the more I want to go home. Coal trains didn't run anymore, so they tore up the track. It was full steam ahead to the future, and they didn't look back. The ones who called us backwood hicks back then are all the same folks moving in. I'd love to go home, but home isn't there anymore. What I'd give to see the eagles soar and hear the mountain lion roar. I'd love to go home, but home isn't there anymore. Oh, I'd love to go home, but home isn't there anymore. It wasn't there. I found that out. Home wasn't there anymore. You ever tried rooibos tea? It's a South African tea. It is so good. I love it. Growing up, the morning show that we watched, all of us kids watched before we went to school, was a clown named J.P. Patches. And J.P. was, he was hilarious. Sometimes his humor was so much that it would kind of go over the kids' heads, but the parents would understand what he was saying. But there was one thing I remember is he would, once in a while, he would play Perry Como singing "The Bluest Skies You've Ever Seen Are in Seattle." And except he was on a station called KIRO, Cairo. And there was a competing station in Seattle called Como, K-O-M-O. So when Perry Como would come on singing, he would say, "Oh, kids, listen, it's Perry Cairo." So that's kind of where I get my strange sense of humor. J.P. Patches. A lot of my friends from the Seattle area would remember him. "The bluest skies you've ever seen are in Seattle, and the hills the greenest green in Seattle. Like a beautiful child growing up, free and wild, full of hopes and full of fears, full of laughter, full of tears, full of dreams to last the years in Seattle. In Seattle, when it's time to leave your home and your loved ones, it's the hardest thing a boy can ever do. And you pray you will find someone warm and sweet and kind, but you're not sure what's waiting there for you. The bluest skies you've ever seen are in Seattle, and the hills the greenest green in Seattle. Like a beautiful child growing up, free and wild, full of hopes and full of fears, full of laughter, full of tears, full of dreams to last the years in Seattle. In Seattle, when you find your own true love, you will know it by her smile, by the look in her eyes. Set of pine trees in the air, never knew a day so fair. They could feel so proud you could cry. Bluest skies you've ever seen are in Seattle, and the hills the greenest green in Seattle. Like a beautiful child growing up, free and wild, full of hopes and full of fears, full of laughter, full of tears, full of dreams to last the year in Seattle. In Seattle." Yeah. Perry Como. That's Perry Cairo, kids. Yeah. J.P. Patches. All my Seattle friends will remember that. I want to do a couple of country songs because, I don't know about you, but my first love really was country music. I love all the singer-songwriters. I remember listening to all kinds of stuff when I was growing up. 'Cause Mom listened to everything. She would listen to anything from Buck Owens to Black Sabbath. It didn't matter. Whatever she could get her hands on, she would listen to. But Dad loved his country music, and he loved Charlie Pride, and he loved, Buck Owens was one of his favorites. He listened to all kinds of people. And I remember going, they would take me to all of the country music shows when they came to Nashville. And I was just a kid. I wasn't even, I don't know, 10 years old at the time. And but I remember seeing all these country music stars, and they would walk out on stage, and I was like, oh my gosh, because I knew we were going to see at a show, because they would walk out in all their rhinestones, and man, they were sparkling. They had their boots and everything, and they looked so amazing. And I thought, oh my gosh, that's what I want to do when I grow up. So here I am kind of doing it tonight. You know, I'm not on the stage like I normally am, but we're still doing it. One of my favorites is a favorite songwriters is a guy named Johnny Russell. Mama said, don't go near that river. Don't be hanging round old Catfish John. Come the morning, I'd always be there, walking in his footsteps in the sweet Delta dawn. Born a slave in the town of Vicksburg, traded for a chestnut mare. He never spoke a word of anger, though his load was hard to bear. Mama said, don't go near that river. Don't be hanging round old Catfish John. Come the morning, I'd always be there, walking in his footsteps in the sweet Delta dawn. Catfish John was a river hobo. He lived and died on the river bend. Thinking back, I still remember, I was proud to be his friend. Mama said, don't go near that river. Don't be hanging round old Catfish John. Come the morning, I'd always be there, walking in his footsteps in the sweet Delta dawn. Let me dream of another morning and a time so long ago, when the sweet magnolias blossomed and the cotton fields were white as snow. Mama said, don't go near that river. Don't be hanging round old Catfish John. Come the morning, I'd always be there, walking in his footsteps in the sweet Delta dawn. Come the morning, I'd always be there, walking in his footsteps in the sweet Delta dawn. In his footsteps in the sweet Delta dawn. Yeah, I love country music. Always have, always will. It's one of my favorites. I remember one of my favorite memories is driving down the road with my dad. He had a, I think it was like a 1952 or 53 Chevy stepside pickup truck. And he would, it was the coolest thing. It was yellow. And it had the rounded hood, and it had those, it had like six windows in it. It had the windshield, the passenger and driver's side windows, and the back window, but it had the round windows on the side that you kind of see out, and it had the starter was on the floor, and it had a choke on the dash, and but it was, and it had the wing windows. And then not only the wing windows, but down on the floorboard, it had the vents that you had to open up, and you had to keep those open because the fumes were just so bad in it. You know, you'd probably die before you got to wherever you're going. But I remember he had, it had an AM radio in it, and he had it like welded, every one of those buttons welded to the local KAYO, the country radio station. So I listened to a lot of country music going down the road in that. He loved Buck Owens, and so I want to do a Buck Owens song. Poor boy's chances at a pretty girl's glances are sometimes very few. Though I have nobody, if you'll be my honey, here's what I'll offer you. I'll give you love that's above and beyond the call of love, and I'll never ever make you cry. I'll give you love that's above and beyond the call of love, and love's something money can't buy. We met by chance, but I knew at a glance that I'd found my destiny. Now I wanna carry you off and marry you if you'll just agree. And I'll give you love that's above and beyond the call of love, and I'll never ever make you cry. I'll give you love that's above and beyond the call of love, and love's something money can't buy. Love's something money can't buy. There's some Buck Owens. I've noticed, I haven't been able to read all of the comments coming through, but I've noticed I've had a couple of requests, and that radio behind me, this radio, man, I've been trying to write out the story. My mom wrote out this great story about this radio. It's a 1936 Zenith console radio. This was my grandparents' radio. And she's got a great story. My mom had a great story about all the things that she heard on that radio, including the announcement of Pearl Harbor. And they would listen, like on a skip, they would listen to WSM and the Grand Ole Opry. So hopefully soon I'll be able to get that story out there, and maybe we'll do a little mini concert of songs that maybe they heard on the radio. So. 1936. It's and it still works. I won't turn it on now, but it still works, and I'll come down here and I can still listen to WSM and all that. So that's the story about the radio. Thanks for asking, Kent. I know my friend Sean Berg asked for a song earlier, and I think I did this a couple of weeks and put it out on Facebook. So, but I'm happy to do it in again because I love anything by Gordon Lightfoot. If you could read my mind, love, what a tale my thoughts could tell. Just like an old-time movie about a ghost from a wishing well. In a castle dark or a fortress strong, with chains upon my feet, you know that ghost is me. And I will never be set free as long as I'm a ghost you can't see. I could read your mind, love. What a tale your thoughts could tell. Just like a paperback novel, the kind the drugstore sell. When you reach the part where the heartache comes, the hero would be me. But heroes often fail, and you won't read that book again, because the ending just too hard to take. I'd walk away like a movie star who gets burned in a three-way script. Enter number two, movie queen, play the scene of bringing all the good things out in me. But for now, love, let's be real. I never knew I could act this way, and I've got to say that I just don't get it. I don't know where we went wrong, but the feeling's gone, and I just can't get it back. If you could read my mind, love, what a tale my thoughts could tell. Just like an old-time movie about a ghost from a wishing well. In a castle dark or a fortress strong, with chains upon my feet. But stories always end, and if you read between the lines, you know that I'm just trying to understand the feelings that you lack. I never knew I could feel this way, and I've got to say that I just don't get it. I don't know where we went wrong, but the feeling's gone, and I just can't get it back. There's a Gordon Lightfoot song for my friend Sean out in Seattle, I think she lives, still lives in Issaquah, which is really cool. I know it's changed so much. Let's see, I also had a request for another ballad, and if you don't mind, I'll do another ballad. Let's see, I'm trying to remember what key I did. And I've got some friends over in like Belgium and Britain and some in South Africa, that they all get this show after we record it, so they don't get to see it live. But they always ask for this song, and I know that one of my other friends has asked, I can't remember who, but had asked for this song, Leonard Cohen thing. I heard there was a secret chord David played, and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do ya? It goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof, her beauty in the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to a kitchen chair, she broke your throne, she cut your hair, and from your lips she drew the hallelujah. 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 Baby, I've been here before. I know this room. I've walked this floor. I used to live alone before I knew ya. And I've seen your flag on the marble arch. Love is not a victory march. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. 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 I know there's a God above, but all I've ever learned from love was how to shoot at someone who outdrew ya. And it's not a cry you can hear at night. It's not somebody who's seen the light. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. 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 I did my best, it wasn't much. I couldn't feel, so I learned to touch. I told the truth, I didn't come to fool ya. And even though it all went wrong, I'll stand before the Lord of Song with nothing on my tongue but hallelujah. 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 Yeah, there was a request for the Leonard Cohen song. Thank you very much. Thank you. I'm glad you enjoyed that. I've got time for one more song. And I had originally planned on doing this outside tonight, but the forecast kept calling for rain and kept calling for rain, and I thought, yeah, no, I'll just set up downstairs, and you know what, we haven't had any rain today, and so I'm sorry. Maybe next time we'll be able to do, Christy Hall, you might recognize this cup. Your dad sent this to me. I had played for one of his benefits one time, and Bringing Hope to the Children of Haiti. This is a cup from Trinity Hope, and they're an amazing organization. They feed school children down in Haiti every day when the kids go to school. They're guaranteed breakfast and lunch, and they've got they've got food every day. So, Christy, thank you, and thank your dad. It's actually one of my favorite cups. I love this one. I've got time for one more song, and it is Memorial Day weekend. You're welcome. And I hope you're all out there and enjoying the weekend. I know we've got this virus thing going on, and we're not exactly quarantined, and a lot of places are opening up, but I hope you're getting out there and enjoying it. Memorial Day is to honor all of our veterans that gave everything that they had. And it's no secret, I love my country. And we're very blessed. And I feel like wherever you are, whatever country you live in, you should also love it. You should love where you come from. And we may not always agree with the politicians and people, but we're given the right to make changes, or at least try to pursue making changes. So, absolututely. Bless our troops. But I want to play one of the sweetest love songs that I have ever heard. And I hope you enjoy it as much as I do. And again, thank you all for so much for coming out and joining me this evening. Oh, beautiful. Oh, spacious skies. Above the fruited plains, America, America, God shed his grace on thee. From sea to shining sea, all beautiful for patriots' dream that sees beyond the undimmed by human tears, America, America, God shed his grace on thee and crowned that good. From sea to shining sea, America, America, God shed his grace on thee. And crown that good with brotherhood. From sea to shining sea, America, America. Thank you so much for coming and joining me this Memorial Day weekend. I hope you have a great day tomorrow. And we'll do this again sometime soon, all right? See you soon, folks. Good night.